This is a perpetual motion machine, a fountain that's flowing forever. Scratching your head right now? Did I just build the impossible? Welcome to Impossible Science. Perpetual motion machines are a mythical machine that actually generates power. It'd be like having an engine that's producing power, but it's not running on coal or oil or even fuel. Now, the idea of a perpetual motion machine is nothing new. There's records of a machine like this going back as early as the 1100s, with Bhaskara, a Hindu mathematician who decided he was going to build a machine that works continuously by just using weights and wheels. If we could create something like this, it would be free energy for all. You could change the world. So why is a perpetual motion machine impossible? Well, it violates what we know about science so far. See, energy can't be created or destroyed. It can only be transformed from one form to another. So the idea of filling up this container so that gravity makes the water go down the hose enough to fill itself back up, this would be impossible. But I do know an experiment that looks just like this, and it's not a trick.
So what makes the perpetual motion fountain that I built in my backyard impossible? Well, I shrunk it down so you can see what's actually going on. Take a look at this clear hose. If I fill up this reservoir a little bit, the water goes to the lowest point. No surprise, right? It sits right here. But take a look at this. The water doesn't just sit down here and fill up one side with the reservoir. It fills up both sides equally. They're coming up to the same height. And if I fill up more water, same thing happens. When this settles, they'll be equal heights. So there's no way to actually put enough water in this reservoir to be able to push the water back to go higher than the top of this reservoir to fill itself back up. Because as I add more and more water, well, you guessed it, it's just gonna overflow at the lowest point. So there's no way to get this water to pump back into it, which is why what you saw in my backyard, well, that's an illusion. But there is a water fountain I'm gonna show you how to make that looks like it works on its own. It has no pumps and it looks like magic, but it's not a trick. It's called Heron's Fountain. Now, I know it's just a couple bottles and some tubes I've put together, and I'm gonna show you how to make this. But this is really cool, because with a little bit of water, I can get the fountain to start. Now, there's no pumps, no hidden compartments, just science. There it goes. Now, with just a little bit of water, the water pushes down into this chamber. And then this forces air into this chamber, which then pushes water down, which through a tube goes back up to the top, which then forces water back to the bottom, which then forces air to the top, which then forces water to the top of that chamber. Pretty crazy, right? So even just a little bit of water gets the whole thing started. Now, this looks like a perpetual motion machine, but it's not. Unlike the perpetual motion machine I showed you at the beginning, Heron's Fountain's water flow will stop when the water supply container becomes empty. All right, let me show you how to make it. For this experiment, it's super easy to build, but the steps can get confusing. So I've color-coded some of these parts. You're gonna need a tube. This is a 14-inch tube. It's kind of rigid. It's about 3/16. You can get these at a hardware store or your model shop is the easier place to find them in. Now, the reason I say this is a 14-inch tube is because the length of your tube determines the height of the fountain. So this is 14 inches. You want a bottle that is about halfway. Now I couldn't find one at 7, but this is 8 inches. So that's close enough. You're gonna need 3 bottles, about half the size of your tube. You're gonna need some silicone, a drill bit that is the same diameter as the tube you're using, and a drill gun. Make sure you have adult supervision, but it's a pretty simple build. All we're gonna have to do is just drill some holes in these caps of the bottles. We're gonna build this. Now, these are the chambers. We've got A, which is the top of the fountain, chamber B, and chamber C. And to make it easier, I color-coded the straws. Now notice, the green straw and the red straw actually have to go the farthest. The red straw actually goes from the very bottom of chamber A all the way down to chamber C. Same with the green one. The blue one, in this case, you're gonna cut it so that it can reach from the top of chamber C to the top of chamber B. Right? So this blue length, in this case, because the bottle is 8 inches, I made it a couple inches longer. So this is 10 inches and the rest are 14. Now, to make this fountain, I put the bottles side by side because I have square bottles here. I wanted to make them line up. So I just put a little mark there. I'm gonna take these caps off and I'm gonna glue them together with the silicone. Eventually I'm gonna have to drill them, but I've learned it's easier to just glue them first, let them dry, and then drill them together. That way, the holes line up. So all you have to do is put some silicone on it, glue it. I twist to make sure that it's gonna be nice and airtight, and I just lined up those lines. The next thing we need to do is we need to make that chamber A part connect to chamber B. And to do that, I'm gonna put that cap right in that indention right there. And glue that. I lined it up again with those marks. I'm just gonna glue one inside there. Now this will only work if the chambers and the tubes are airtight. So make sure you take your time to actually make them airtight. And don't worry, if you have any problems, you can always go back and put some extra silicone in there. Now we have that one, and we have this one. Unfortunately, we have to wait till these dry so that we can actually drill them. Once you've had some time to let these caps dry, we're gonna drill two holes through them, all right? And they can't be connecting holes. They just have to go from one side to the other, but two separate holes. So it'll look like that, clear through. Then we need to drill two holes through this cap into this chamber. All right, just like that. Now back to the diagram. This is the B chamber. That cap is attached to this chamber. And this goes onto the bottom of chamber B. That's right there. Here comes the hardest part. You need to get that red tube, or in our diagram, the red tube that goes all the way from the very top of chamber B, actually just in the very bottom of chamber A, to go through the bottle, through the cap, and into chamber C. Now to do this, I do this part first. If you take a close look at this, I'm not gonna push it any farther than that. I just want it to make it into the chamber. So it just has to make just past chamber B and into the beginning of chamber A. Now to put this cap on, we actually have to put the tube through the cap and then twist it on. So it's gonna get a little tricky. Put this on like this. Now, if the holes up here and the holes down here don't line up that much, don't worry. There should be enough flex in the tube to be able to make that work no matter how off line they are. You can see mine is diagonal actually. So from A through B into chamber C. Now comes that shorter one. The shorter one is gonna go up through the second hole in here and it's gonna stop before it reaches the top of this bottle. There it goes. So it looks like that. Add that silicone again in here, just to make sure that these stay airtight as well. You can tape this off if you need to. I might, just to give it a little more strength rather than just wait on the silicone to dry. And we're almost done. Now take the green one, or this last straw. You don't have to cut it. It just goes down to the bottom area of chamber B. And last but not least, we have to make the top of the fountain. And to do this, we just need some scissors to cut off the bottle. Now, I do this kind of last because I'm gonna cut up here. And then what happens is as I fill this up, I wanna see where the water actually squirts out because right now it would just squirt out the top. So I might have to clip this down to kind of make it the right proportions for these size bottles. But you can see where this is going. I just cut off the bottom of this bottle, but I'm gonna flip it upside down and that'll be the top. And I screw it on like this. And there you have it, chamber A. With the green tube that goes all the way to the bottom of chamber B. Then you have this chamber B, and inside there you have a blue straw, or you have a tube that goes from the top of this one to the top of this one, to the top of chamber C. And from C, you have one tube that goes from as low as you can to just inside the top up there. You screw on this one, you screw on this one, and you use silicone to make sure it's airtight. Now to set this up, all you have to do is flip it upside down. Now, I know there's a little bit of water here, but what's really happening, once it gets started, is air will be forced up to here, which then is filling up this chamber. Once all the water's out of this chamber and back in this one, you're ready to go.
Now that you understand that perpetual motion machines are impossible, back to my original question. How does this work? Think you know the answer? Let me know in the comments below. and stay curious, because the right question changes everything.